So good morning, class 12 students. Today we will learn regarding the features of planning, right? So altogether there are 7 features of planning. Okay, we will learn one by one all these features. So the first feature of planning is that planning focuses on achieving objectives. Okay. Planning focuses on achieving objectives, right? So under this you can say that as specific goals are set out in plans along with activities undertaken to achieve them, planning has no meaning unless it contributes to the achievement of predetermined goals or objectives. Okay, so this is one of the features, that it focuses on specific goals are set. Okay, number one thing, and predetermined organizational goals have to be achieved, and planning has no meaning unless contributes to the achievement of predetermined goals. Okay. Right? So these two things you have to write in a manner so that this point can be clear to all, right? That planning focuses on achieving objectives as specific goals are set out in plans. Okay, specific goals are set out in plans. Okay, and at the same time, planning has no meaning unless contributes to the achievement of predetermined organizational goals or objectives. Okay, then second thing you will have to learn is the primacy of planning. That means planning is the primary function of management. Planning is the planning is the primary function. Primary means basic. The management process starts with plan or planning. Okay, so it provides the basic of all other functions. All other managerial functions are performed within the framework of plans drawn. Okay, so number one thing, it provides the basis for all the functions of management. It provides the basis for all other okay? And second, what you will write in this, that all other managerial functions are performed within the framework of the plans drawn, okay? All the managerial functions formed okay within the framework of planning, right? Plans drawn, right? Thus planning provides other functions, okay? When planning will be done, okay, we will be able to know that what is what are the boundaries, what are the limitations under which we have to work, then the whole organization will work or other functions will be performed. This is also referred as the primacy of planning. It is also known as primacy of planning, right? So this what you will write in these two points, okay? Considering these two key points and these three key points, you will explain these particular two features of planning, okay? Then we will move ahead, have a look, okay? So that you can be able to make the notes afterwards, okay? Then next we will take planning is futuristic process. Okay, third feature of planning is futuristic or planning is futuristic process. Okay, why futuristic? Because whatever we do in planning, we are doing for actions in future to deal with the future circumstances. Okay, we are preparing now for the future. Okay, it is also, you can say that planning involves looking ahead and preparing for future. Okay, it is planning involves looking ahead or planning involves looking ahead or preparing for future. Right? So, preparation regarding the future course of action is planning. Right? So, the purpose of planning is to meet future events effectively and efficiently. Right? The purpose of planning is to prepare or meet future effectively and
efficiently.
Right? At the same time, it is looking ahead. Okay? Planning is therefore regarded as a forward-looking function based on forecasting. Okay? Looking ahead function, it is forward looking function based on forecasting. Okay? Okay, you can say forecasting, prediction, okay, these terms you can use. Through forecasting, future events and conditions are anticipated. You can assume them, okay, anticipation means assumption, and plans are drawn accordingly. Okay, so forecasting is, that's why essential, because forecasting the future events and conditions, okay, a particular anticipation is prepared and plans are drawn accordingly. So through forecasting, future events and conditions are anticipated and accordingly plans are drawn. Right? So that is why planning is futuristic process. Okay, you can take example that on the basis of sales forecasting, an organization prepares its annual plan for production and sales. Okay, by anticipating the future sale. Okay, sale forecasting. Okay, so this is what is the third point. Then, right, so this is what is the third point. Then fourth is, planning is pervasive. This word we have learned in the beginning of the lesson number one also, when we were discussing the features of management. Pervasive means which is required everywhere. Okay, requirement of everyone, whether they are from the same organization or they belongs to different organizations, whether they are they belongs to a particular country or foreign country. Okay, so planning is required at all levels of management as well as in all departments in the organization. Okay. Number one, it is required at all levels of management as well as in all the departments of the organization. That means it is not only required by a particular department, it is the requirement of each and every department. Okay, it is the requirement of each and every level in the management. Okay, everybody needs planning. That means everybody have their own plans. Okay, without planning nobody should action. okay, it is not an executive function of a particular department, say top management. Okay, you can write this thing also. It is not an executive function of say top management. Right? At the same time, you can take the examples that it is what plan managers at all levels do. Okay? That means planning is done by every manager at every level in the organization. Okay? We had discussed while discussing the different levels of management. Okay? If you think regarding planning, so top management plans for the whole organization. Middle level management prepares their own departmental plans, okay, and at the lowest or supervisory level, supervisors formulate day-to-day operational plans. Okay, you can take the example, top management plans for the whole organization, that what organization have to do, okay. Middle level managers plan or make departmental plans, okay, and right? So top management plans for the whole organization. Okay. Middle level managers make their own departmental plans. Okay. Supervisory level make day-to-day operational plans. Okay. Top, middle, and lower. Okay. Top management prepare for the whole organization. Okay. Middle level have their own departments. Okay. Production, finance, marketing, HR, okay, and supervisory level, as they are the supervisors, foremen, clerks, so they used to make routine plans or day-to-day operational activities plan. Okay, so please note down. Then the next feature of planning is that planning involves decision making, right? Planning involves okay, in the meaning itself we discussed that planning is a process of deciding regarding future course of action. Okay, that means you have to choose among the various alternatives available. That is why planning is called a process of decision making. Okay, as it involves choosing the best alternative from among various alternative course of actions. Okay, it involves examination and evaluation of each alternative and choose the best or most appropriate one. Okay, so planning involves choosing the best alternative. It involves choosing the best alternative among the various and how to choose the best, or how you will say that a particular alternative is best, by proving it by examining, that means examination and evaluation of each alternative. So it is the work of, or it is the feature of planning, that it involves decision making, as it involves choosing the best alternative among the various alternatives available. Okay, and best alternative we can choose, okay, by proper examination and evaluation of each available alternative, right? So we'll discuss the sixth point. I want you to please note it down. Then sixth is, planning is a continuous process. Okay, that means it is not the work of one single individual. At the same time, it is not the work of a particular time period only. Okay, although it is when we used to do planning, it is suggested that it should be time bound, but that time bound situation should be applicable to for a month, okay, or a quarter of the year, or for a year. At the end of that period, new plans have to be prepared. Okay, so plans or planning is done for a specific period. Okay, at the same time, after completion of specific time period, new plans have to be made or prepared, right? So once the plans come to an end, so after the completion or after the end of that period, new plans have to be made. Okay, so it is not only at the end of the period new plans have to be prepared on the basis of new requirements and future conditions. Okay, new plans have to be made. Okay, hence planning is a continuous process. Once a plan is framed, it is implemented, and then it is followed by another plan, and so on. Okay, so once the plan is framed, it should be implemented. Once plan is made, it is implemented. Right? One thing. And second thing, and then it is followed by another plan, and so on. And it is followed by another plan, and so on, as per the requirement of the future. Okay, or the conditions. So these are the 3 points which you will write under planning is a continuous process. Number one, planning is done for a specific period of time. Okay, after the end of that specific period or after the completion of that specific time period, new plans have to be prepared. That means once plan is made, it is implemented. Okay, the time period is over, then it should be followed by another plan, and that another plan should be followed by another plan. Okay, and so on. So that is why it is a continuous process, because we want our business firm should work, okay, on a continuous basis. So that is why it is required to have new plans according to the prevailing situation or future expectations. Okay, so future can be dealt easily by having continuous planning, right? Please note down these points, and then we will discuss the last point of this topic. Point is that planning is a mental exercise. Planning is a mental exercise. Okay, how mental exercise? Because it requires application of mind and sound judgment, good judgment of future conditions or assumptions, right? So it is required application of mind, it is required application of mind and sound judgment, right? That means whenever somebody is doing the planning, okay, so they need to apply their mind. Okay, they should be having, it is not the work of everyone, okay, to have a good plan. Good plans are made by those people, those who apply their mind properly, okay, who used to have good judgment about the future conditions, okay, those who can judge properly the or anticipate properly the future happenings, okay, taking into consideration the environmental factors, okay. So that is why it is an intellectual activity of thinking, okay. It is intellectual activity, it is activity of thinking, okay, the work of intelligent people, okay. So it is intellectual in nature, okay, rather than thinking, rather than doing work, because planning determines the action to be taken, okay. It is more of thinking work rather doing work, right? And what else you can add, because it determines future course of action. Because it determines future course of actions to be taken. Right? So these are the points which you can write under planning is a mental exercise. That number one, it is required application of mind and sound or good judgment. It is an intellectual activity of thinking. Okay. It is more of thinking work rather than doing work. Right? Because, okay, the answer for this, because it determines future course of action to be taken, right? So these are the seven features of planning, okay? Please note down. So as these are the seven features of planning, with this I hope I am clear on all these things. You understood what is the theme behind features of planning. With the help of these key points, you make your own notes. Okay. Try to solve some questions in the question banks provided. Okay. And at the same time, keep learning these points so that you can have a proper picture regarding this particular topic. Okay. In the next session, we will discuss the importance of planning. Right? Please find one more attachment of notes as well as the questions so that you can be able to solve the future questions in the board exams. Till then, keep learning, keep revising, be safe at your home. Thank you very much.